Have you been looking for a good quality combat knife that won't break in a fight but also won't break your wallet? Well, welcome back to the Frankenvet Experiment, where we not only give you the knowledge but the confidence in all of your tactical, survival, and firearms purchases. Today we're talking about the OKC SP1 Gen 2, or otherwise known as the Ontario Knife Company Spec Plus 1 Generation 2. Bam! Stay tuned. This 12-inch full-tang combat knife has a black epoxy powder coat, 7-inch 1095 high-carbon steel blade, and a molded black Kraton grip weighing in at only 9.9 ounces. It actually does come with this leather on the back right there, nylon on the front, and cardboard insert sheath when you buy it as well, so you get both these in the package together. Now, I've actually been using the SP1 Gen 2 in my kit for almost about 5 years, but I actually carried an SP1 Gen 1 with me while I was deployed, and I have to say that I love the Gen 1 almost as much as I love the Gen 2. In fact, my biggest complaint about the knife when I first bought it was that this top side groove right here wasn't sharp. It was actually dull. It was like a fake edge almost. And so I actually spent hours and hours and hours grinding that down and actually getting it sharp. Now, the SP1 Gen 1 and 2 both come out of the box extremely sharp. So I've actually had to sharpen this once in the last 5 years, and I can still cut paper with it. It's just an amazing blade. It's super, super hard, super strong. And I love that. So I want to get into some more of this. First off, this knife is a workhorse. The 1095 carbon steel makes it extremely strong. I have used it for digging holes, building shelters, batoning, splitting wood. And honestly, no matter how much abuse I put this thing through, it just doesn't give up. Now, I have heard a lot of people be pretty upset about this right here, the guard not being steel, kind of like how the competitors have it. They have a separate piece in the steel and it goes across right here. But that being said, this wavy Kraton molded guard seems to hold your hand perfectly, and it just little to no chance of slipping, and it's just comfortable. I've never been afraid of being hurt by that. So, and also as well, this more boxy rounded grip right here, this design seems to hold my grip a lot more organically than the competitor's more rounded grip. That's almost like a cylinder, or kind of like a, I guess almost an egg style, but this whole box to it seems to give it that really positive front and back feel and makes it very comfortable. This is actually MSRP's at about $69.95. On Amazon, I think you can pick it up for around $35, $34. So this actually comes in about $40 cheaper than its next closest competitor, which would be the K-Bar 1211, I believe, or the, you know, 1211. But that's almost $40 cheaper. So that is just amazing in my book. And I'll actually go ahead and I will put links to the products that I talk about in the description below. So if you want, go ahead and check those out after this video is over. But I do have to say that for as much as I love this knife, it does have its downsides. First of all, the Kraton molded pommel right here with a brass, if you can see that, eyelet that goes through the bottom of the tang to hold it in. I will say that I do not have as much confidence in that design as I do with K-Bar's steel pin and pommel traditional style. I've never had any problems with it necessarily, but I definitely would say that out of the two, I do prefer that other style just a little bit more, as in quality in the craftsmanship. As well, you can definitely tell where Ontario made their cost cutting in this very mostly cardboard and, you know, extremely flimsy, poorly made sheath. And I don't like it at all. I actually have constructed using a K-Bar Kydex sheath and some other G-code stuff, my own system, so I don't even actually use this myself. Now, maybe you're balling on a budget, and being said and done, for anyone that's looking for an inexpensive quality combat knife, or something that you're not afraid to go take out and abuse, but you still want it to stand up time and time again, I highly recommend this knife. If I'm being honest, I would actually choose this knife over the K-Bar 1211 regardless of price, just because it feels just that much more comfortable in my hand personally. So if you get the chance, go ahead, pick one of these up. I guarantee you won't regret it. And now it's your turn to tell us, what knife would you take into combat? Don't forget to put that down in the comments below. Also, if you like today's content, hit that like and share button, and don't forget to subscribe so you can keep up to date with all of our ever-growing weekly content. As always, I'm Franken Vet. Stay smart, stay safe, stay alive.